That never gets old. So, I have been giving it a lot of thought, how to do the tracks, and obviously we're going to put it down this tunnel here, right? Well, of course, I mean, where else would we put it? There is only one little hitch when it comes to that, and I just realized I never actually... One second, I'll be right back. I forgot all the golden iron. Hey guys. So, decided I'd look these up while I was in the house, and did you guys know that the recipe changed? Because I sure as heck didn't. I could have sworn, just like regular rails, this made 16. Well then, we might end up needing more gold after all. But, whatever. We need them, so we make them. Anyway, let me go ahead and make up another one real quick. And for real this time, I think I will meet you guys back down there in the tunnel. Okay, so here we are, down in the tunnel. And I actually gave this a bit of a test on my private world, because when Notch put these in the game, I had to go and change all my tracks because they were all the old booster style, so I decided to give this a shot. And wanted to see how this worked out. And, well... actually... no. Probably not. It's gonna be... anyway, started thinking about how I was gonna actually put this down, and, I mean, the obvious idea was to go ahead and run it here along the side. At least obvious to me. Move the torches, or put some glowstone out there, I don't know. Make it look nice. And so we were going to run the tracks, kind of like this. The only problem being that when you want to throw down the booster, that works all well and good, but they don't bend. And in this case, I'm pretty sure the cart's just going to go thunk, and it's going to be like, well, that was a fun ride, now what? Now, what I was just thinking a second ago was that maybe we could get away with doing it like this. We put this here, and we got that. So that way this bends, at least. And then... stop it. There we go. Now you see, this will sort of work, because as the cart's coming along, it's going to bump up to here, and then you're immediately going to get switched and come off this way. So, this might work, but I'm pretty sure you're going to have a real nice jarring motion as you do the switch here to this thing. So, with that in mind, we'll come back and test this real quick, because I actually hadn't even considered this. But with that in mind, throw these lights back down. That's good enough. So with that in mind, I decided to get started on a little something else last night. Spent a couple hours, and I think it's coming along pretty well. I stopped myself about halfway through, because... more burping, yay. Stopped myself about halfway through, because with all the caving we've been doing lately, I figured it just wouldn't be right if I started doing all sorts of building without you guys, so let me turn around and show you what I had gotten started. Yeah. I figured, you know, since we made this, let's do something useful. And the idea behind this new tunnel is that rather than the diagonal, really awesome diagonal tunnel that we made here, we should instead just aim for a straight right angle. You know, just all the way down to Resurrection Station and then take a hard right. And, well, I've gone all the way down, so what's left is the hard right. And let me kind of show you guys how far I took this thing. You can see we're that since I have the glass, we are definitely completely underwater here. And what's interesting is I think right about here, possibly, maybe a little further back, the ocean just drops right out from under you. And from surface to ocean floor is about 12 or 14 blocks. It is really deep out here, and so making sure this tunnel stayed up here was a bit of a challenge. And a bit frustrating, which is the other reason I got started without you guys, is as frustrating as it was to build the awesome diagonal thing, I wanted to, you know, be off camera for this to get started, and good news, I found some interesting new ways to build tunnels inside water, especially these nice 3x3s that I like. And that's something I kind of wanted to show you guys. So as you can see, we're here, we're all the way down, we are underwater. Hey look, squid. And we're getting ready to head this way. Now for anyone interested, this is exactly 130 Z. And so that is the line we're working with, as that actually ends up, if you recall the back wall in Resurrection Station, you know, we come down the ladder, we've got the Smeltmaster 5000 over here, and this is the back wall, pretend. That's about 3 or 4 blocks inside that wall. And why inside the wall, you might ask? Well, I'll let you guys consider the possibilities. And I will let you guys know what I was planning when we get to it. Putting some of the things together that I've said recently about plans for the future might be a bit too much of a hint, but I'm just going to go ahead and continue throwing that out there. So, let's head back, whip up ourselves a minecart, and see what that's like. Because, I mean, since I'm over halfway done with this new tunnel, I'm pretty sure I'm going to stick with this. Because, I mean, a big reason for putting this new tunnel in, the big reason for putting the tracks in down here in the first place, was to get back home as quickly as possible. So that way my stuff would stop despawning, because it's a really long walk back. And this is probably the most disorganized you'll ever see any of my chests. I just wanted to get back to work with what I was doing, so I never really bothered making anything look nice. Okay, so minecart. And I grabbed the redstone torches already. Excellent. Alright, let's go try this out. I'm pretty sure it's not going to be fun, but we'll give it a shot. And you know what? While I'm thinking about it... No. Wrong way. I always get that backwards. Button. Want a button. And not a shovel. There we go. Okay. Give ourselves a nice starting point. So I think if we do this... Okay. Put that here. Put that there. And... No. Oh, guess I didn't need to make a button. After all. This A lever will work just fine. Oh well. Now we got a button. Yay! Alright, so. Let's see what this is like. Yeah, that was kind of messy. And I'm not entirely sure, but... Oops. Not entirely sure, but it felt like bumping up against the glass was slowing me down. Which is not a good thing. Let's try that. Oh, yeah. Wow, we didn't even go the right way. Huh. So, if for the sake of argument I was to put a block here, would that work? Let me... I swear I've done this before, guys, just not with these boosters. Oh, yeah. That's not pretty. Because I think the other idea was to... Well, let me go ahead and set that up, and I will show you guys in a second. Okay, so this was the other option, was run it more or less down the middle. I don't know why, but for some reason I thought there was a center, but it seems like there's a left side and a right side. Or a left side and a right side, depending on however you're looking at it. But I think this might have been the original idea, and then I thought maybe if I ran it along the walls it would work. But if we do this, and I forgot the redstone torch again. I am new to the redstone, guys. Hey, look, I remembered to turn it off this time. All right, if we try this, we get rocketed off the wrong direction again. So we add a block. We wait for the mouse to scroll. Scroll too far. Try it now. It's just not smooth. Because ordinarily, if you were to build this nicely, in my opinion anyway, with it all like this, you get the advantage of the game almost being too confused as to whether you should be facing right or left, whether you should be turning right or left, that you just end up going straight. And I love that about diagonal tracks. And that was one of the things I had in mind when I was building this, is how great that would be, because you even get a speed boost out of it. You're even able to, I think, accelerate a little bit faster than the, what is it, like 8 meters per second max that there is for minecarts in this game. Now, there is something I was able to figure out in my private world that if you do, let's see. No, that's not quite right. That's right. You do like this, I believe. No, you need to come up first. Oh, really? Since when do you do that? Anyway, I think it was something like this. Good, that does power all of them. Yeah. Well, regardless, I think until Notch fixes this, I mean, if that happens in 1.8, awesome. But I don't know, I think that's a little too late. So for now, to get the really nice feel, you can actually see the lights. That's cool. We're gonna go with the tunnel that we're that I guess more or less goes around the long way, but because we're actually going to have boosters every 30 tracks, this should work out pretty well, I think. So, let me go ahead and clean this up, and let's see. What time is it? We should make another watch. Okay, good. The moon is setting. The sun is rising, I guess. So let me clean this up. I'll get organized and head back over there. And I will show you guys my new trick, or at least new construction method for building these tunnels that has worked out pretty well so far. So, once again, see you guys in a few. Okay, finally organized. Decided to spend a little time and organize the chests as well, because they were looking a little messy. So, as we head back down this way, we get another glimpse of. Hey, cool. You can see our other tunnel. Nice. So, yes, that is the goal, right over there. Or, I guess over there. Anyway. So, let's head down here, and I will show you the new interesting way, the new interesting construction method, I guess, that I have been working with. It's probably nothing new to some of you, but I like it as it's been about 100 times more hassle-free and just completely rage-free, because there were times when I was digging out that other tunnel that I was pretty much ready to give up. It was just that frustrating. I'm going to have to figure out another interesting lighting scheme for when I finish this all up. But let me go ahead and show you guys this. Let's see. Pretty sure. Yeah. Let's actually fill that in for now. The first thing that's actually been helping me a lot, you know, not having to fight the water currents. And, I mean, that was probably like 60 to 80% of the headache building that other tunnel. Well, something, little trick I picked up from watching other videos. Give the water somewhere to go. Now look what happens. Look at that. And every single one you knock out, all flow to that hole. No headaches. It has been the greatest discovery I have made in a while, and looks like we're about to run into land soon. Cool. So, I might actually be able to show you guys this entire process. So, what we do, get dirt in hand, swim up to the surface, find the edge. This should be the edge. Alright. Get some air, and head on down. And it's gonna get really dark, but just hold down, right click. And as soon as you hear yourself place a block, start swimming back up, but don't let go of right click, so that way you build your wall up instantly. Now I'll do the same thing on this side. Swim on back up. And let's see. Why, yes, we're gonna hit land pretty quick, so. Let's see, is there something else I can talk about while we do this? Let's see. Yes, I guess something kind of important I should mention. And this might end up affecting certain things that have happened recently. Nothing that would affect you guys directly, but anyway. I have noticed... Well, okay. Let me step back and say something else. As I tend to do. The thing I actually did want to mention is that because in episode 97 I mentioned that what SMP weekend was partially being used for, you know, the auditions, as I was saying, well, now that the cat is out of the bag, as they say, well, now that I have gone and said that, I think it should be fairly obvious that future SMP weekends will no longer be auditions because... One, I don't want you guys feeling all uptight, like you've got to be on your best behavior, and you always have to ask my permission for something. I mean, it's there for us to have fun together, so if you feel like you're always on the spot trying to do the right thing, which, I mean, yeah, I guess you should always try to do nice by everyone else on the server, but also, I don't want people who now have heard this acting nice, thinking that, ooh, hey, if I get invited to the next SMP weekend, and I act really nice, maybe Nocturne will invite me to do the... So... There's that. So, it's no longer auditions, they're still going to happen, but... I'm not sure when the next one's going to be, actually. So, because the SMP Choose Your Own Adventure tour server that I've got set up for everyone right now is actually using the SMP weekend server right now, so I can't really run two servers on that machine. So until the tour comes down, and like I said, that's probably through at least the end of the month, the SMP weekends were probably going to be on hold, which is not a terrible thing. It just means it's going to be a little while. And there we go. That's one wall. It gets a lot harder to do at night, I'll say that. But I think it's great we're already at some land here. I think we're going to bust in the water again on the other side, as this is just an island. But this is not bad. Actually, while we're at it, let's light this up a bit. Don't want anything spawning and jumping on my head, especially fun green things of either the dead or undead variety. So, just add a little bit of light up here. I think I know what this is. Yeah, I think... No, this is an actual island. Okay, it's over there. That's the little land bridge. Way back from episode 0, if you guys remember. Now, that was a long time ago. So. Add a few more lights here. And I think I might, depending on how things go, just jump ahead to after I finished putting up the other wall and kind of show you guys how I was working the ceiling. You might notice I have these in my hand. They come into play, so I think I will just go ahead and jump ahead now. Ooh, look at that. There's a spider island over there. Those beady red eyes. Ooh, creepy. Ooh. This is gonna look beautiful when it's done, guys. I mean, look at that. Very nice.